This video is sponsored by DistroKid.
Honest question, does anybody go on Instagram and unironically follow music production tips? Because of the nature of the content I post, I always get shown music production tips. And half the time, they're all so not good. I think for today, we can go through and actually try out what they're suggesting. It could go either of two ways. I could potentially learn something really new, or we can disprove them and we can roast them. It would honestly be cool if some of them gave good advice. 100% better beats if you use this method. Ear candy. Good for layering some notes and melodies. I think it's more the presentation of information, because the information itself isn't bad. What are you doing here? Go make music. Oh, I'm sorry. I'll open up Ableton now. I love being shamed by Instagram pages. Oh, here we go. Bass synth cheat sheet. Okay, this is one we should try. It's so hard to read. Okay, so what does it say on it? Let's make just like a quick little... Okay, don't judge me yet. Okay, so bass, cheat sheet, rumble, boost here to give more weight. So 100 to 150 hertz. Okay, so this is around to 150 hertz. Let's start boosting it. I'm not feeling the power, man. I don't feel the power, bro. Mud, cut up to 3 to 4 dB to get rid of muddiness. Okay, so this will be 200. Now let's get rid of all that mud. Bro, need some OTT. No, we're not doing that. We're using the cheat sheet. As you can see, boost can give more presence and definition to sound. All right, let's go. 3 to 5. I can see that actually works. Bro, it sounds better without all the EQing so far. Honestly, okay, this is what I would do. First, instead of just boosting where like a cheat sheet tells you, figure out the key of the song. Right now I'm writing an E. If we want this, if we want power, move it to like the E or like E2. So you can see in the corner here, like what note it is, and give it a small boost. You don't need to fucking, can't see the corner. Where does it say the note? Oh, my head's over it. There. If you mouse over like any part of the EQ, it'll actually show you the note down in this little corner. Before we even like do anything, this bass synth needs like crazy sidechain. Yeah, because it's more of a mid-range bass. So actually what I would be doing, this would all be gone. I would do that and then I would just make a sub channel. What else does this cheat sheet say? Definition and presence. I kind of did do that. And honestly, you know what? I guess that 3 kHz for presence, definition, kind of helped. This area might need a low pass depending on the sample. Okay, so it's not completely wrong. All right, MD3 design, you got me with that one. What's next? Get the most of reverb. Don't use too many types of reverb. What else we got here?
Excuse me, why are you still scrolling through the memes when you could come off as an actual, true blue, serious music producer? Now you may not be replying to me this time, but trust me, being serious music producer artist can easily be done through today's sponsor, DistroKid. And once you sign up, by the way, 7% off with the VIP link, you get access to amazing perks, just like instant Spotify verification. Look at that gorgeous check mark. And the ability to upload Spotify canvases to your song, just like this. Look, click this, and then you 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 upload it. If you really want to be the meme star on Instagram, use the meme generator. DistroKid's got a meme generator. Make meme videos of your music. And if that $20 a year is still scaring you off, just remember, VIP link. From Ash. Ash, this is the one you're watching right now. Him gets you 7% off your first year. Go ahead, do something. You don't have to waste any more time scrolling through these fluffy, motivational Instagram posts from... Hey, wait a second. Isn't that...
How to make kick heavy. Okay, layer with the sub. I have layered it with the sub. I did it, guys. Oh wait, you know what? According to this, I should be doing that. Hang on. I'm doing it wrong. I should be doing that. I think that adds too much boominess to the kick, honestly. Okay, as we look at this, if you have a proper sidechain, you don't need to take out all the bottom of a kick. If you're gonna be doing bass sounds, when you're rolling off an EQ, especially on bass sounds, don't use this steep roll-off, because what this is four of these. And what that ends up doing is it phase cancels out the lower end. The point that I'm trying to make is, when you have a proper sidechain on, especially with like an LFO tool like this, it'll smoothly go from kick to sub without any clashing. Sidechain properly. So if you do this step, you don't need to do step one. It depends on the genre though, for sure. You can use automation as well. Saturate for power. All right, let's do that. Okay. We're gonna saturate for power, but he's not gonna tell us how to do it. Increase the input drive and play with presets or saturate by yourself. Saturate by yourself? I'm gonna do this by myself. I think it sounds great. We saturated to give it power. All right, what's next? Layer kicks. No, it's already too loud. Yeah, I guess we're layering a kick. I think this is considered torture for producers. What should we layer it with? I need to hear what these guys' music sounds like. Yeah, he says add a layer. I'm gonna add another layer. I'm gonna try and find one that could potentially work. When will you do the next Twitch review stream? It'll be on Monday. Oh, no, I do have a kick here. All right, that's a good one to layer it with. Better sound amazing. But we're also gonna be smart. We're gonna EQ. Pain is the only thing I know. All you can hear is kick. Okay. Oh, new sample pack out this Friday though. Just making sure everybody knows it. But honestly, I think having this as a layer isn't the worst idea because it's got that nice click to it. But if I was to not EQ it, it would just be a disaster. If you can take anything from this, production is like 90% volume balance. If the tips are excellent, I can't imagine how professional the sample packs are. Gosh, mixing. Mixing is just volume balance. Say you level up as a producer, that's what we mean, because you find out proper levels for everything. And honestly, guys, that just comes with practice. Keep making songs, keep writing. Oh no, these are just like super vague. Don't trust words. Trust actions. I don't even know what key this song is in. I really need to put a meme page in my Discord. If you learned something, if you had fun, like, subscribe to the channel. Join me on Twitch. I'm live every Monday. Follow my socials. I see all your DMs. Other than that, I'll see you later. Peace.